Good Monday morning! I am MPJ, and you are watching FunFunFunction. This video is a video series on object creation in JavaScript. I will not be teaching general object orientation principles. This video is for you if you're already familiar with object orientation, but you are confused how to apply it to JavaScript specifically. At the end of this series, you will, hopefully, if I do my job right, be a lot less confused about the prototype, classes, bind, object.create, modules, factories, constructors, and all that stuff. This first episode will start out very basic. We will be looking at how the this keyword works with object literals and bind. That is it. So why begin with this and bind specifically? Well, it's because it's very important to understand this and bind before we try to tackle anything else, because they are very fundamental to how object creation works in JavaScript. If we don't understand bind, almost nothing about object creation in JavaScript is going to make sense. First of all, let's talk a little bit about the state of JavaScript. So first of all, there's something a bit emotionally taxing that we will need to tackle right away. There is no right way to do object creation in JavaScript. One of the strongest feelings I remember from when I was first learning JavaScript was asking myself, how do I create a class? And you start reading about it, and it is this rabbit hole where you try to understand what a prototype is. And what's worse is that there are different opinions on how to create a class, and different opinions on whether or not you should create a class at all. And you get very confused. And this, let me do it, and this is going to be very, very hard for your soul to deal with. So you need to give it some time. Because your soul will want JavaScript to be like Python. Python is a language that is very tightly controlled by a single Dutch middle-aged white guy, and he decides what is the right way of going about things in Python. JavaScript is different. JavaScript is arguably the biggest programming language in the world. And it's also pretty old. It's been around for 21 years. Oh, it's raining a lot. I'm not sure if you hear it, but I need to close my window. Which is sad, because I think that the sound of rain is like the best sound ever, but I'm afraid that it will mess up the sound. Anyway, biggest programming language, 21 years. Like, seniority, it comes with its perks. JavaScript is installed on goddamn everything. And there will be free pre-written packages for doing goddamn everything too. It's good being on top, but there's also some baggage that comes with it. Some languages, like JavaScript, are standardized. There really isn't a default JavaScript environment. JavaScript is not like Java or Python, where you can go to, you can't go to javascript.org and download JavaScript. No, JavaScript has four, all very good, competing engines. They're made by Google, Microsoft, Apple, and Mozilla. This is possible because it is a standard, but in order for there to be a standard, these companies all need to sit down and agree on how the language should look. A process like that requires compromise, and that is why there are a lot of different ways of going about things in JavaScript. Because, you know, people and organizations are different, and we have to get along. With that long digression, I just want to say that in order for you to learn how object orientation works in JavaScript, you need to accept that there isn't a right way to do object orientation in JavaScript. Instead, you will need to learn how object creation really works in the language, and then figure out what is the best for you, for your team, and for your set of problems. I promised that I would teach you about bind in this episode, so let's look at some code. Let's look at a basic object. Okay, so we have an object literal here, dog. It has a property, sound, that we have set to the string woof. And we have a method named talk, which prints out the sound property to the console. So when we call dog.talk, we get woof. So this is the kind of essence of what I mean when I say an object in the context of this series. It doesn't necessarily have to be a class or something with the prototype or anything. It means that we have some functionality like talk that is bundled with some data and tied to some data, like woof. So looking at this code, even if you are coming from a non-JavaScript environment, this is probably not going to confuse you too much. You might think it a little weird that you can instantiate a dog just like this without declaring it a type and instantiating it, but overall this code is probably not going to confuse you too much. But let me fix that for you. I am going to let talk function equals dog.talk, and then I'm going to call talk function, and this will output undefined. What? When you first run across this, you're probably thinking something in the lines of what the fuck shit ass. And that's okay, that's a normal reaction, that feeling of confusion, it's your friend, it means you're learning. Let's just calmly have a look at what happened. So we took the dog.talk method and we reassigned it to a variable, and then we called that variable and that returned undefined for some reason. Let's first talk about the fact that in JavaScript, I can assign a function to a variable. Because this is not something that you can do in all programming languages. You can do this because JavaScript is not only a object-oriented programming language. JavaScript is also a functional programming language. Let me give you a history lecture on the background of JavaScript. The first version of JavaScript was created by another middle-aged white guy. His name was Brendan Eich, and he was sort of lured into this project by being promised that he would be allowed to create Scheme in the browser. Scheme, by the way, is a very cool functional programming language that he liked a lot. But as the project started to take form, his manager asked him to, can you make it look a little bit more like Java? Because at that time, Java was actually considered to be a cool programming language. This was 1995 and cell phones looked like this, and Jay Leno co-hosted the Windows 95 launch. So it turns out that JavaScript is this bastard child of Scheme and Java. And I know what you're thinking, what the fuck shit ass, but you need to learn to love this thing. You need to learn to love JavaScript because it's going to stay here for a very long time. And just like with your human best friends, you need to accept their quirks in order to really appreciate them. But either way, because JavaScript has this Scheme heritage, it also has higher order functions. Higher order functions is an amazing feature, and it allows us to do a ton of really, really cool functional programming in JavaScript. I have an episode, and actually a whole series, on explaining why higher order functions is such a good thing and how they work. You can find it by clicking in the upper right corner on the I. You can also find it in the episode description. But you can check that out later. What's important in this context is that functions like dog.talk, like this one, are values like any other value, like string or number. So I can stuff them into a variable just like I would be able to with a string. But in this code example here, this mysterious undefined that we get here, it's an example of how the object-oriented nature of JavaScript clashes with its function-oriented nature. In languages that are oriented around functions, like schemas, there is no concept of this. It's not there. But in object-oriented languages like Java, this is absolutely essential for the language to work. When we are reassigning a method to a variable like this, it is now no longer a method. It is just a function. It has kind of ceased to be a method connected to an object. It's now just a free-flowing function. So when you call it here, this is no longer going to be the dog. It has kind of ceased to be, not exactly ceased to be, but it has lost its connection to the dog object. It's going to be like execute here, and it's going to come to this, but this is no longer going to be the dog. If I inline this code, like it might help you understand it better. I'm going to put this here and paste it in. So we call talk function here, and it's going to execute this here, but like this. There is no this really in this context. It's just a function, right? See? So in a function, the this keyword, it does not refer to like the context where the function was defined. It refers to the context where the function is being called. However, we can bind it to that context by using the function bind. Let me show you how that looks like. I'm gonna just do this very explicitly and call it bound function. And I'm gonna talk function dot bind, and I'm going to bind it to the dog. And now I'm going to change this call to be bound function, and now this is going to console log out. Woof. All right, so bind here is going to take the talk function, and it's going to return a new function here that has bound dog to the this keyword. So bind forces this to be dog in this case. And it is because of this funkiness that you will run across bind in a lot of JavaScript code. Let me simulate an example that looks a little bit more like a real world example. So let's say that we have a button. So here, we assign the talk method to the click handler of the button. But when the click handler is being called, this is not going to be the dog. It's going to be the window object, actually, because that is where the add event listeners are being triggered. But that's kind of beside the point. The point is that it's not the dog. Therefore, people will solve this by here. They will type bind dog. So now what is being passed into the add event listener function is not the vanilla talk function. Instead, it's going to be a new function which has bound this to the dog. If you have made it this far, good job. You have learned a little bit about bind, which is one of the most tricky parts about JavaScript to understand. And we've learned a little bit of history, which helps us understand why JavaScript looks the way it does. I've talked a lot, now I want to ask you something. What do you want to see next? Because, you know, this is a video series and I have not yet decided what to talk about next. And I figured that I'd just ask you. What confuses you about object creation in JavaScript? What concepts would you like to have cleared up? Write a comment down below and I shall be happy to oblige. I will also be putting all the episodes in this series in a playlist, which you can find by clicking the i in the upper right corner or in the episode description. You have watched an episode of FunFunFunction. This is a programming show that I release every Monday morning, 0800 GMT. You can check out the channel below and look at the videos and see if it's something that you would consider subscribing to. It would make me very happy. And if you really, really liked it, you might also want to follow me on Twitter. I am MPJ, this is FunFunFunction. Until next Monday morning, stay curious.